Kingitu Heitia breaking ground on what's become a lucrative tribal business. A five-star hotel going in at Auckland Airport, the fourth hotel in a growing Waikato-Tainui portfolio.
The occupancy rate for these hotels is about 90%, so it's a major cash cow for us.
Costing $150 million, the project is an equal partnership between the iwi and Auckland Airport. It'll go up right next door to the Novotel, which was also developed jointly.
Partnership is critical to our success, and it's a key part of our DNA.
And it's not the only large-scale project underway.
Eight major infrastructure projects are underway or expected to start in the next 10 years, including a second runway, a new cargo facility, and new roads, all expected to service growing passenger numbers, expected to be 40 million by 2044.
Most visitors in New Zealand hub through Auckland Airport to get through the rest of the country, so really good infrastructure is extremely important.
Increasing visitor numbers meaning some projects have been brought forward.
These are challenging projects. They're like making a bed while you're sleeping in them. We keep the airport running while we're doing the project.
You're going to employ over 300 people at the hotel. You're probably, when it's finished, going to employ 200 permanents, and then you're going to be able to accommodate the top end of town. It's a good thing for Auckland.
Waikato-Tainui, now more than 20 years post-settlement, are worth $1 billion. Today, also about remembering who got them here.
This day, which marks the birthday of Te Ariki Nui, Te Atairangi Kahu, our late Māori Queen.
The tribe recognising her in this latest venture, the hotel to be named Te Ariki Nui Pullman. Yvonne Tahana, One News.